Hey, greetings everyone. This is Brother Clint and welcome to the Word Prophet channel once again. This is a Christian ministry dedicated to the purpose of preaching the Word of God to the people in the churches of God so that we can go back to serving God in spirit and in truth as Jesus Christ commanded in John 4:24. What you're looking at is a passage of the scripture in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, and the reason that we're here is because a sister wrote to me today and she said that a man who professes himself to be a pastor told her that when a man commits fornication with a woman, that makes them married to one another. And that's, of course, ridiculous, and no such thing is true. But I want to go through the scripture with you so that we can understand this basic truth from the scripture. So let's just read the scripture as it is written. May God give us understanding as we enter into his presence by his word, and may God bless the reading of his word. 1 Corinthians 6:15 says, "Know ye not that your bodies are the members of Christ? Shall I then take the members of Christ and make them the members of an harlot? God forbid." Now what does this mean, your bodies are the members of Christ? What it means is that those of us who are in Jesus Christ, which is, you know, this letter was written to the church at Corinth, so this letter was addressed to people that are baptized in Jesus' name and filled with his spirit, walking in his commandments. And those of us who have been baptized into Jesus' name and filled with his spirit, we have become espoused, betrothed, to Jesus Christ. He is the bridegroom and we are the bride, and therefore we are bone of his bone, flesh of his flesh. We haven't been to the wedding yet and consummated our marriage with him, but we are betrothed or espoused to him, as I explained in an earlier video this evening. So our bodies are the members of Christ. Just as if you have a wife or a husband, your body is the member of your wife or husband's body. You are bone of his flesh, flesh of his flesh, bone of his bone. Your bodies are one. You have become one flesh. That's what a marriage does. It causes a man and a woman to become one flesh. Well, we have become one flesh with Jesus Christ, the Son of God, because that body that he died on the cross 2,000 years ago has become our body because we are baptized into Jesus Christ and filled with his spirit. You see? So we are now the members of Christ. We are his bride and he is our bridegroom. And so Paul says, "Know ye not that your bodies are the members of Christ? Shall I then take the members of Christ and make them the members of an harlot? God forbid." What if one of us who was married to Jesus Christ decided to sin against the Lord and fornicate with a harlot? For those of you who don't know what a harlot is an English word that means a prostitute. So what if one of us should go into a hotel and make ourselves intimate with a prostitute? We would be making ourselves the members of an harlot. We would be joining ourselves to a harlot. Does that mean that we are become married to the harlot? No, of course not. He says in verse 16, "What? Know ye not that he which is joined to an harlot is one body? For two, saith he, shall be one flesh." All right? "Two, saith he, shall be one flesh." This is what God said in the beginning. "For this cause shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh." Twain is an English word that means two. They twain shall be one flesh, you see? But he that is joined unto the Lord is one spirit. So, again, verse 16, "What, know ye not that he which is joined to an harlot is one body? For two, saith he, shall be one flesh." So when a man and a woman make vows to one another, and then they go into the marriage bed and they consummate their marriage, they become one flesh. They join themselves one to another. So if after they join themselves one to another and they're married, the man goes and commits fornication with a harlot, or adultery rather, with a harlot, he is joining his body to that harlot. And therefore, he is at the same time, he is joining the harlot body to himself. And then he brings home to his wife whatever was in that harlot's body. See, if that harlot was a member of witchcraft, if she was a participant in other various satanic things, those things are in her body. Whatever spirits that she has drawn into herself or allowed into herself by her actions are dwelling in her body. And then that man joins himself to her body and gives permission to every uncleanness from her body to enter into his body. And then he takes that home to his wife. What is that called, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls? It's called adultery. Adultery. The reason it's called adultery is because the word adulterated means to corrupt, debase, or make impure by the addition of a foreign or inferior substance or element. To adulterate something means to take something that is pure and add something that is foreign or inferior or unclean in order to make it impure, to corrupt or debase it. That's what adulterating means, and that's why it's called adultery when a person who is married joins him or herself to another person and then brings that filth or that uncleanness back into the marriage bed. That's why it's called adultery, and that's why God said, "Thou shalt not commit adultery." So you see, when a person who is married joins himself to another person outside the marriage, they're joining their body to that person. It doesn't mean that they are becoming married to that person, because they're already married to someone else. What it means is that they're joining their body to that person and giving permission or opening a door for everything that that other person had inside their body to enter into their body. That's why people get diseases on a physical level, in the physical realm, from fornication. That's why you can get what we call STDs, or sexually transmitted diseases. Because if you have sexual intercourse with somebody that you're not married to, if that person has a disease, then when you're having sexual intercourse with them, that disease becomes transmitted into your body. The only way that disease can get transmitted into your body is by having sexual intercourse with them. It can't happen by having a conversation with them or writing them emails or talking to them on the phone. It can only happen by engaging in sexual activity, and that's called joining yourself to someone. Okay? When you join your body to another person's body, when you know someone carnally that you don't have the lawful right to know carnally, because you're not married to that person, that's called fornication if you're unmarried, and adultery if you are married. And it is something that causes you to become impure and corrupted. And then if you're married, you bring that corruption and impurity back to your spouse and adulterate your marriage. That's why it's called adultery. All right. Now, if you're not married, does having sex with someone, having sexual intercourse with someone, make you married to that person? No, of course not. And again, that's a ridiculous notion. But let's just look at Exodus, and this is this is the 22nd chapter, and we're going to look at verse 16. It says, "If a man entice a maid that is not betrothed and lie with her, he shall surely endow her to be his wife." What does this mean, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls? It means when a man who is not married will entice a maid, which means a young woman who is not married, okay, a maid that is not betrothed, and lie with her. What does that mean? It means to have carnal knowledge of her. It means to have sexual intercourse with her. He shall surely endow her to be his wife. So the act of lying with her doesn't make her his wife. But the act of lying with her means that he has committed fornication with her. In this case it is called fornication. And therefore, he shall surely endow her to be his wife. Okay. That's, you know, the old rule that I've heard since I was a boy when I was a kid. You don't hear about that anymore, but, you know, when I was a kid, if you're a man and you have sexual intercourse with somebody's daughter, then their parents are going to say, "Hey, congratulations, now you're going to marry her. You've defiled my daughter. Now she's yours. You have to marry her." Have you ever heard of a shotgun wedding? That's when the parents come to the wedding with shotguns and say, "You marry my daughter because you have defiled her. Now you have to marry her." That's a law. That's the law of God. So having sexual intercourse with a woman does not make you married to her, but it's called fornication, and it does make you indebted to become married to her because you've defiled her. She's not a virgin anymore. So let's go back to 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 15 through 20. So he says, "Know ye not that your bodies are the members of Christ? Shall I then take the members of Christ and make them the members of an harlot? God forbid. What? Know ye not that he which is joined to an harlot is one body? For two, saith he, shall be one flesh. But he that is joined unto the Lord is one spirit." You see, so is Paul saying that when you join yourself to a harlot, that you're married to her? No. It says, "Know ye not that he which is joined to an harlot is one body?" Don't you know that when you join yourself to a harlot, you are sharing everything in your body with her and sharing everything in her body with you? You're joining your body to her body. And whatever uncleanness that she's been involved in now has become yours. Congratulations. "For two saith he shall be one flesh." What you're doing is not joining yourself in marriage to this woman. What you're doing is sharing something with this woman that is in that was intended for the covenant of marriage between a man and his wife. That's why he said, for two saith he shall be one flesh. When you take what was intended for a man and a woman in covenant with one another in the covenant of marriage, and you apply that outside of marriage to somebody that you're not married to, that's called fornication or adultery, depending on the circumstance, whether you're married or not. If you're not married, it's called fornication. If you're married, it's called adultery. If you join yourself to a harlot, you're joining your body to hers, and that's something that you don't have the right to do if you're not married to her. So if you're not married to her and you join yourself to her, you're making your body one with her. That doesn't mean that you're married to her. It means that you're mixing yourself with her in a way that is not lawful. And that's what Paul is talking about here, and that's why he says, flee fornication. Every sin that a man doeth is without the body, but he that committeth fornication sinneth against his own body. Why? He that committeth fornication sinneth against his own body. Well, the reason is because what I just explained to you. Because if you come across a woman and you're not married to her and you decide to have sexual intercourse with her, everything that she has been exposed to, every door that she has opened to every devil in her life, every door that's been opened by every man that she's ever committed fornication with, every unclean spirit that is in her, every curse that has fallen upon her, every physical sickness that has come upon her body because of the acts that she has done in the past, now become yours, and you sin against your own body. And if you're a Christian, if you're a recipient of this letter, 1 Corinthians, your body is the member of Jesus Christ. And so then you will have taken your body and put it in a situation where you have made your body subject to the curses, devils, and diseases that have been brought upon that woman that you are fornicating with, or that harlot that you are fornicating with. So that's why Paul says, flee fornication. Every sin that a man doeth is without the body, but he that committeth fornication sinneth against his own body. When you commit fornication, being a Christian, you commit fornication, you not only sin against the Lord, you sin against your own body. You're defiling your own body. Remember what adulterate means? To corrupt, debase, or make impure by the addition of a foreign or inferior substance or element. And that's what you're doing when you're married to the Lord Jesus Christ, but you go and have sexual intercourse with a harlot. You are committing fornication and you're sinning against your own body. Now look what Paul says. What? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own? If you're a Christian, you are not your own. Your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost. Your body is not for fornication. It is for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. That's what the scripture says. And it says here, for ye are bought with a price. Therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. See, you are not your own. You are not your own. You are bought with a price. You are the property of somebody else. You belong to Jesus Christ. He bought you with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. And so this is obviously a lesson against committing fornication with harlots. And a harlot isn't always necessarily a prostitute who charges money. A harlot can be a woman who just will have sex with anybody, just like, you know, the parable of the two sisters in Ezekiel chapter 16. So this is a lesson to tell us that if we belong to Jesus Christ, we are the members of Christ, and if we join ourselves to a harlot, we become one body with her. That doesn't mean that we are married to her, and the fact that a man commits fornication with a woman doesn't make him married to her. We learned that from Exodus 22:16. And if a man entice a maid that is not betrothed and lie with her, she does not instantly become his wife. He shall surely endow her to be his wife. That's the responsibility that he will have if he has defiled her by committing fornication with her. So committing fornication does not make people married. And that is the lesson that I wanted to share with you in this particular video. I hope this was a blessing to you. Stay in the Word and on your knees. The Lord is coming soon. Amen.